Oh my god! He's arrived. What Hero heard wasn't the sound of construction, but it could have been an explosion! Huh? Or maybe a machine gun! That can kind of sound like a construction in a way! What are you talking about? Beyond this point, my mouth is zipped! My lips are sealed! I am fully puckered! It's a secret little secret!
And?
Fine, then let's move on to what you can tell us. Why did you call us all here?
Say what?
You don't beat around the bush, do ya? Ready for me to get to the point, huh? But before that, you mind if I vent a little? I'm low on energy these days. My stitching's even losing all its shine and luster. I'm thinking it's probably become of this ho-hum, boring old everyday life. I'm looking for something with a little more stimulation. Something rife with danger and intrigue.
Yep.
Listen, can I just be frank?
Today,
the net's black and hasn't shown up yet, and I'm getting bored!
Hey,
So, I decided to come up with a new way to motivate you. Motivate? Uh-oh, this didn't turn out good last time. Is it another set of videos or something? Are you gonna show us some demented thing to try and drive us all to murder? Drive you to murder? What a mean thing to say! Just awful!
You hear me?
I don't know what you've got planned, but we're not gonna kill each other anymore.
Got it.
No matter what you do, I swear to God we won't. That's very big talk! Do your very best to back it up, okay? Now then, with your permission, let me begin! So this time it's... Uh-oh. Embarrassing memories and secrets. As long as you're alive, it's a given that there's things you don't want other people to know about you. So I did a little investigating of my own, and I dug up some of your darkest secrets. Oh, no.
And those embarrassing memories and secrets are all contained in the envelopes I have right here.
That's fucked up.
I'm going to hand them out now. So take a second to take
Excuse
a peek.
Me, sorry. As Monokuma spoke, he tossed the envelopes at her feet. I quickly snatched the envelope with my name written on it. I nervously pulled out what was written inside. My entire body suddenly went rigid. Uh-oh, what did you do, Makoto? Makoto wet the bed until he was in fifth grade. What the fuck? Why would I kill anyone over that? I would just be like, yeah, you know, until I was in fifth grade, I just pissed myself, and I'm sorry, okay? That's not worth killing anyone for, what the hell? What? How'd you find out about this? Everyone started talking at once. I hope your guys' secrets aren't as stupid as mine, because if they are, I mean, really, we're not going to kill someone over these, are we?
You have 24 hours! If someone doesn't become blackened by then,
Extreme! All
your deepest, darkest, most oh my god. Secrets will be exposed to the world!
Jesus. Oh my god, okay.
Maybe I'll roll by a crowded intersection in a van strapped with loudspeakers and spill the beans!
Yeah!
Yeah! Wouldn't that be so embarrassing?
So that's what you meant by motivate.
Yep, you got it! They're all pretty unpleasant, trust me. None of you want me to reveal that stuff, right? It's definitely something I'd rather people not know.
Oh, it's Makoto again, damn it. Whatever. We'd never kill someone over this.
What?
What'd you say?
Count on it.
He's right. Your plan is doomed to fail. No one's gonna murder someone for this kind of thing.
This is kind
of pathetic. No.
Is it because, for better or worse, your memory is still a way to connect to the outside world? I have stuff I wouldn't want anyone to know no matter what, so I assumed you'd all be the same. Which is why I put so much effort into preparing this next motive. Man, you're saying you really won't kill each other over this stuff? That just sucks. Well, what can you do? Okay then, in 24 hours I'll expose all your secrets just to make myself feel a little better.
Okay.
So sad, so depressed, fare not well.
With an almost convincing look of depressed dejection on his face, Monokuma receded into the gym's depths.
So,
I didn't know what to expect at first, but maybe we dodged a bullet on this one? I mean, yeah, having those secrets revealed is gonna be totally embarrassing. But that's seriously not enough to give someone a reason to kill, right?
Listen to me!
Unless one of you jackasses has a really messed up secret. Besides wedding bets. Good news, everyone. I have a brilliant idea.
You hear me?
Why don't we all just confess the secrets in those envelopes right here now?
Without a doubt.
If we do that, any and all motive for murder will vanish. That's pretty smart, right?
Quiet down
okay,
and listen.
So my embarrassing thing is...
I don't want to hear your stupid story. What? Besides, I don't want to talk about it. I don't care what anyone says. I don't want to talk about mine.
As for me...
Neither do I. Not because it is unpleasant, but because it is impossible.
Oh?
Well, it's just human nature to want to hear it when you say it's impossible. Come on, it'll be good for you. Absolutely not.
Come on.
It's okay, just a little bit. Come on.
Honestly.
As I said.
Here we go.
Come on.
Hey!
I said I don't want to talk about it, you human bag of lard.
Say what?
Gah! Jesus Christ. I agree with them. There's no need to discuss it. What do you think, Chihiro?
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I don't really want to talk about it right now.
But
I also don't want to leave things the way they are. So maybe I can talk about it later. After I try my best to become strong, then I can tell everyone.
So.
If you don't want to talk, you don't have to. I'm not super excited to talk about it either.
That's true.
If everyone's that much against it, even if my bro's the one that suggested it, I gotta say no. Well, that's okay then. Either way, if it's just a few secrets, I'm sure nobody's about to kill anybody over it. I hope you're right. A secret's so bad you'd kill someone to keep it. Nobody's got something like that, right? Okay, I'll stop with all the secret talk, but...
You hear me?
Each of us has 24 hours to get ready. Having our secrets exposed isn't gonna be fun, but it's not like we're gonna die because of it. So, you know, don't do anything hasty. The way you keep repeating it kind of makes me worry even more. Okay, sorry. I know it's gonna be tough, but... Wow, okay. I just know one of us has a really dirty secret they don't want to get out. Someone's gonna die. It's just gonna happen. Yes, it's nighttime. Okay, now it's time for bed. Alright. Nighttime already, huh? Okay, let's call it a day.
Of course.
Good idea. We need to prepare for tomorrow. I feel like my sickness makes her voice better. I think that's one good thing about this. I was left with anxiety I just couldn't shake, but we left things as they were, and left things as they lay. One by one, we headed back to our rooms. Oh dear lord, I don't like this. This doesn't feel good. Secrets are memories you don't want anyone to know about. A way to connect to the outside world. Honestly, all that crap Monokuma was spouting didn't have any effect on me. Yeah, because all yours is piss in the bed. There's no way anyone would kill over stuff like that. At least, that's what I thought. But maybe I was just being optimistic. Which is probably why, without too much of a struggle. Jeez, I'm more tired than usual. Super tired today. Oh god, what's gonna happen? I fell asleep. But what I didn't know is that even then, a tragedy was taking place. Oh no, somebody's dying. Oh no, oh please don't be someone I love. Please don't be someone I love. I love a lot of people, so that's gonna be really difficult. Hey, do you have a second? I wanna confide in you. It's about the prevailing world attitude right now. The difference between passive and active? I mean, for example, it's the difference between like, oops, I killed him, and yeah, that's right, I killed him. Amazingly, there are tons of people who don't understand the difference. Can you believe it? But there's a huge difference between oops and that's right. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, anyone can kill someone in the heat of the moment, but surprisingly few can do it without calculated intent. To make that choice then put it into action is way harder than just letting your emotions lead you. It's all about preparation, resolve. So maybe you're wondering, what's the point I'm trying to make? Uh-oh.
Well, I'm not totally sure myself. Maybe you should try reading between the lines.
I'm not really good at that. I'm actually kind of not that great at that. Morning. Good morning.
Good morning!
Oh, it's you. Ah! Up! Nice reaction! I'm glad you see you didn't disappoint! But what? What are you doing in here?
Yep.
I wanted to spice things up, so instead of a school announcement, I decided to wake you up in person! What the hell for? Because it's fun! As long as I'm here, I figured I'd let you hear it right from the bear's mouth! Hear what? Are you sure you should be acting this laid back? I mean, even though something happened to one of your buddy classmates? What?
Say what?
What? Your face is all blue, like someone on the verge of death! What happened? What are you talking about? That's for me to know and you to find out! Good luck!
Oh no, something happened to someone. Was it? No, it can't be. There's no way someone would. But what if... No, what ifs are pointless, especially now when... The dining hall. I need to go to the dining hall. Oh no, who is it? Please don't be someone I love, please don't be someone I love. Who is it? Who died? Uh-oh, there's lots of people missing.
Ah, Makoto!
Are you okay?
Hey.
Did Monokuma talk to you too? Hirohina, Sakura, and... Byakuya. You're the only ones here? Where's everyone else? Either they're already off trying to verify what Monokuma said, or they've fallen victim to the something that Monokuma mentioned. The something?
Perhaps.
It can't be. Has it happened again? Murder? After hearing what Monokuma had to say, the worst possibility forced its way into my mind. It took everything I had to drive that thought away. So if something really did happen, does that mean someone did it because of what happened yesterday?
Huh?
It can't be. This stuff was just a bunch of old memories. Just old memories? Don't be so sure about that. Clearly, someone felt it was more important than that. Huh? To judge someone else's value based on your own outlook, do you realize how dangerous that is?
What the heck?
Why didn't you say something yesterday?
Naturally.
Did you already forget? This isn't a co-op game. It's every man for himself. What good does it do for me to get out of my way to help you?
Just the worst.
Stop saying that already!
There's
something wrong with him, for serious. Did he get brainwashed or something?
Wait.
That's not important. What matters right now is that we find out what happened.
That's fine.
She's right. Let's all split up and begin looking. The game is afoot. Oh shit, so I have to find the dead body now, don't I? God damn it. I don't like this. I'm gonna assume it's gonna be on the second floor? And not on the first floor, so that's where I'm gonna look. The first murder was already on the first floor. Okay, let's see. Let's check out the pool area. I feel like this might be a promising area to look. Anything? I'm not seeing anything. Bathroom, maybe? Huh? The door's open, but aren't these supposed to be locked? Uh-oh. What are you ding-donging about? We just woke up.
For this investigation, I have unlocked the doors.
Okay.
Please look around to your heart's
Okay. Investigation?
It's all clear now.
Just as I thought. Byakuya!
I see.
Judging from what he just said, there can be no doubt a murder really has taken place. Come on! In the locker rooms, they're suspicious. Very suspicious indeed, wouldn't you agree? Huh? Suspicious? Seems nobody searched the locker rooms. Let's start with the girls' locker room. He was muttering as if talking only to himself. Without waiting for a reply, he pressed his hand against the girls' locker room door. Oh no. Oh no, don't be like Chihiro or something. The door swung open without a sound. Oh dear god, oh no. I don't know if I can take this. Okay, let me just collect myself. Okay, it's gonna be okay. In that moment, time seemed to freeze. Oh dear god, okay. Oh no. Bloodless. No, it is Chihiro! No, god damn it, why? The one person I said not to be! What the fuck? God damn it, not Chihiro. What the fuck? No! God damn it! Oh my god. What? I don't know how long it took for me to fully comprehend the reality of what I was looking at, but as soon as I did... Oh my god, who would kill Chihiro? Who would do that? Who is that fucked up in here, besides Byakuya? A wild, almost primeval scream escaped my mouth. I'm sorry, I'm just so emotional right now, I can't even fucking speak. Oh my god. This is the worst. Who would do that? No, damn it. I tried to suppress my screaming, but it was useless. It surged out of me like water from a spring gushing out of the ground. Byakuya, on the other hand. Oh, man.
Strange.
Most unusual, don't you think? He was totally calm, almost like he was watching this all unfold in front of a TV screen.
I see.
Look, Chihiro's corpse has been suspended somehow. Something's been written on the wall in blood. Bloodlust. Such a brutal way to kill someone. No, this is beyond brutal. Wouldn't you agree? They killed her. How could it not be brutal? No, that's not my point. This murder is far too bizarre for any everyday amateur to have committed it. Like with Sayaka, this murder was not a crime of passion or necessity. It's almost as if whoever did this did it for fun. You see what I mean, don't you? What? My head was swimming. I was still really too confused to understand what he was trying to say. Before I could even begin to clear my head...
What the heck?
Hey, I heard screaming. Did something... Jesus Christ, dude, I know. Okay, I know. That's how I felt. Okay, so it's gotta be someone that wanted to kill and they enjoyed it. Now, the only one that's obviously fitting that description is Byakuya, but I doubt it's gonna be him because that's way too fucking obvious. And that'd be way too easy.
A body has been discovered after a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like. The class trial will begin.
Oh my god, this is insane. What the hell was that?
What?
Ah, that's right. You were unconscious during Sayaka's, so you don't know about it. What you just heard was the body discovery announcement. Apparently, when three or more people discover a body, an announcement plays to let everyone know. I imagine so that the search for the culprit can proceed fairly for everyone involved. Proceed fairly? The body discovery announcement? Then Chihiro really is...
Naturally.
Dead. Yes. Before you start screaming your head off, go around everyone up. Seems another game has begun. Another life or death game to uncover a killer. Oh, I can't handle this. Why everyone I love? Why, game? This is like... Why? Taka bolted out of the locker room. Like, I'm curious as to if you play the game a certain way, did the people die differently, or is it always the same people that die in specific orders? I don't know. As everyone made their way to the scene, it felt as if no time at all had passed. It was like my sense of time had just taken wing and flown away. When I finally came back to myself, I saw everyone had the same look of confusion, fear, and anger. We all just stood there, gathered around Chihiro's body. Oh god, okay.
Damn,
I couldn't keep her safe! Oh my god, that is a very scary looking face, okay? So there's another victim!
Which means we are now in the same position once again. She seems like she could fit.
I don't know, maybe. Fuck, man! What the fuck is this?
What?
Is it a dream? This is a dream! It's all just a dream! In fact, I haven't even been born yet! I don't have any memory of ever being alive!
Shut up.
Okay, alright. I guess we're gonna get right into this investigation for Chihiro. We're not gonna let this killer escape. Alright, so this obviously is what killed her.
No, there are more important things to worry about right now than
it has blood on it. It is literally one of the murder weapons, if not the murder weapon. Are you kidding me? What the fuck do you mean there's more important things to worry? Okay, let's look at her body, I guess.
For now, pay attention to the wall.
Huh?
I said it once already. There's a word written there. I fucking see it. It's as clear as day.
On the wall? My character is retarded.
The word bloodlust is written on the wall in blood.
So...
I don't think it's any kind of dying message. It's just too strange. But, you know, that thing about writing bloodlust in blood, doesn't it kind of sound familiar?
Does it?
A murderous fiend who kills again and again using a bizarre and brutal method. And at the scene of each crime, the word bloodlust is written in the victim's own blood.
Oh.
They're like a ghost, attacking suddenly, then slipping away before the police can catch up to them. What nickname did the internet give to this mysterious serial killer? Serial killer?
What?
Genocide Jack? Genocide Jack? The murderous fiend who grisly attacks were famous all across the
Okay. This, you know, it isn't hard for someone to just mimic a killer.
The ultimate murderous fiend, creating a reputation of abnormal, downright cruel killings.
Wait a second, the ultimate murderous fiend? Okay, then he might really be here with us.
What is this?
Then this is some copycat killer trying to imitate Genocide Jack's style? But why would anyone do that?
Perhaps it's the work of the real Genocide Jack. The real? Wait, are you saying Genocide Jack is here in the school?
No way!
There's no way!
But going so far as to write bloodlust at the scene, I am surprised at their stupidity.
Well, I can't imagine a worse situation than dealing with a stupid murderer.
What is it now?
Toko! Hina was pointing toward the entrance to the girls' locker room. Oh no, this isn't blood, I promise. Toko was the last to arrive, and now she was just standing there.
No, why? Why?
Okay. She fainted! That did not sound good! Toko! Hina rushed over to the collapsed Toko and started trying to shake her awake. I still don't understand how she didn't pass out before when the girl was killed right in front of us all. If she's so, like, against- I don't understand. Okay. Maybe they must have just overlooked that. Toko, are you okay? Come on, wake up!
Oh.
Oh, that's right! I just remember what she said about how she faints anytime she sees blood!
Oh.
So she is hemophobic. I imagine she does not watch too many horror films and...
This isn't a violation of the rules, right? I mean, technically, she passed out somewhere besides her room. No, I think it should be okay. The regulations prohibited sleeping, like, on purpose. Ah, so since she didn't faint on purpose, it doesn't count. Gotcha. I hope it doesn't count.
Toko, can you hear me? Hey, you gotta wake up!
As if she'd heard her, Toko suddenly shot awake. As in, she literally jumped up from where she was laying. It was such a strange reaction, I was at a total loss for words. She leapt straight up into the air, changing her stance as she did.
Oh my god! Your tongue is kinda...
You wanna just put that back in your mouth? Okay. In no time flat, she was just standing up. Ignoring the physical contortion she had to go through, her motions were totally haphazard.
Huh? What?
Sorry about that. I was just so shocked, you know? It happens, right? Was I the only one?
Toko, are you okay? She's not stuttering like she usually does.
I'm fine.
Whoa, is that a dead body? Hey, are you dead?
Okay. Oh, wow, okay.
What the heck?
She must have hit her head real hard when she fainted.
The world has a front and back, a top inning, and a bottom, a sea of truth and web of lies.
Well,
this is quite concerning. I mean, she sounds completely different.
No, everything's fine. At least the stutter's all gone. That's a good thing, right?
I see.
It's clear to me that everything is not fine. Your eyes seem strangely vacant.
Mm.
It might be best if we take her back to her room for the time being.
I don't mind taking her, but could someone help me?
Mm-hmm.
If you need help, I don't mind. Taka, could you help me? She totally ignored me!
Very well. You take care of the girl and the rest of us can begin the investigation right away. Can I assume nobody has a problem leaving Sakura and Mondo on guard duty again?
Hold on a second. Rushing to an investigation?
The mastermind isn't behind that. After what happened last time, surely you realize that. There's no question that Chihiro was murdered by someone among us. Isn't that right, Monokuma?
Of course!
Right as rain! But don't take it as a bad thing, it's just a fact of life! Because... that's how graduation works!
Oh, don't show me the body again. Then, it's happened again? Is that what you're saying? That another one of us killed a fellow classmate? I think that's pretty obvious at this point.
What, does that freak you out? You guys got no balls, you know that? Is there just nothing down there at all? Well, I'll let you pray to mine if you want. Actually, I don't have any either! Sorry!
Stop monologuing and give us what you came here to give us. You did bring it, right?
I sure did, chum! Allow me to present the next Monokuma file! I know how much you must be looking forward to it! So, please do your very tippy-top best on this investigation!
You got it, Monokuma!
What do you mean, do we really-
Yes, there's a dead bot. What, you wanna just stare at it?
Oh, god damn it! How many times are you gonna do this view?
Examining the corpse of one of our friends. Having to suspect all our other friends.
Why?
I hate this. I can't take this anymore. Oh. I hate it too! I've had enough! I'm getting out of here!
Hey! Where do you plan on going? There's nowhere to run!
Such
just genius. Accept it already. After all, blood is just a liquid. Dead body is a simple object.
You are very enthusiastic about all of this, are you not?
Naturally.
How can I not be? If we don't unmask the culprit, we all die.
That's true, but to jump into it so soon...
What?
What, do you want to die?
Such ignorance.
Fine, go off and die some. Right now, go ahead. You're a waste of space.
Dead body
is an object?
Piece of
shit! Jira wasn't an object! Show a little respect or I'll beat some into you!
Calm down.
Everyone, stop bickering. Listen, there's some truth in what Byakuya said. Kyoko!
Because...
If we don't solve the mystery and find the killer, our own lives are forfeit. And if Byakuya is right that Genocide Jack is somehow the one who killed Chihiro...
That's right.
Then unless we do something, more victims could start piling up. That would make sense if it is, because if that was the secret, he wouldn't want anyone to find out. Or she, he, whatever.
Forget more victims? If we mess this up, we're all dead meat!
Hold on, hold on! If that's your worry, you don't gotta worry any longer! If any one killing game, the guilty party may only kill a maximum of two people!
Huh? What? I don't remember any rule like that. Oh wait, I didn't do his voice. Sorry, forgive me.
Actually...
I just came up with it!
You can't just fucking add rules like that, god damn it.
I mean, if one person went around and killed everyone, your lovely student life would be all over, right?
So, I guess... Only a person can only kill up to two people, okay?
In that case, why not limit it to one person?
Hey!
Oh, a good mystery! You don't want to miss out on at least the potential of a serial killer angle!
Yeah.
Just one would totally murder that possibility!
Punishment.
Farewell for now! I'll catch you guys at the class trial!
I can't say I understand his thinking, but if we can kill up to two people, then one more person's life could still be in danger. Which is definitely not good. You need to uncover the culprit before something else happens.
You son of a
You bitch. Need to shut the fuck up! So we really need to find this killer before someone else dies.
Well, for now, Taka and me are gonna drop Toko off at her room.
Nice, I'm gonna get dropped off!
There is nothing to be done.
We have no time to stand around here. We must begin our investigation to its sweet.
Okay, I hope I said that right.
If we do not solve the mystery of who killed Chihiro, then we will quickly follow her into the afterlife.
That's true. I hate this, but if I want to survive, me and everyone else, we have to do it. We don't have any other choice. Okay, so now I can investigate. Okay. First of all, I better check the Monokuma file to see exactly what's going on. The victim was Chihiro Fujisuke. The time of death is estimated to be around 2 a.m. Again, once in, you know, at night. The body was discovered in the girls' locker room on the second floor of the school. The cause of death was a blow to the head with a blunt object. She was killed instantly. That's all it says. Well, it's not like there's any point in complaining about it. Excuse me. No matter what, I gotta do what I gotta do. Monokuma file. So that pretty much didn't tell us shit. Hey, Makoto, do you have a second? Huh? Did you need something from me?
Naturally.
Of course. Life without purpose is quite dull, you know? So what did you need?
I'm gonna let you cooperate with me during my investigation.
Huh?
What?
I'm purchasing your talent. The same talent which allowed you to solve Sayaka's case.
Stop talking.
You seem to have some limited use, which is why I've chosen it. You have the honor of contributing to my investigation.
Excuse me! I'm the one that's gonna solve this case, so you can fucking suck it!
So, you're inviting me to come with you. I'm doing it in the most arrogant way possible, though.
Let's go.
Now then, shall we get started? But... We need to get moving. There's no time to be standing around. I don't really know what just happened. It looks like we'll be working with Byakuya on this one.
Okay, anyways, Nell, can I check out this dumbbell?
There's a dumbbell on the floor, and this is a bloodstain. There's a bloodstain on the...
Yeah, you can see that way off from across the room.
The
Monokuma file said a blow to the head with a blunt object is what killed her. Does that mean this dumbbell was actually the murder weapon?
That's right.
I don't imagine it could have been anything else.
Or maybe that's what they want you to think.